Hey guys, I'm not going to do my normal intro for this video because it is a kind of different style video and one of importance. If you don't know, November is American Diabetes Month, and also today, November 14th, is World Diabetes Day. And also, if you don't know, I am a type 1 diabetic. So for today, I thought I would share my story, I guess my diagnosis story, and how my life has been with diabetes for the past few years, and maybe give some advice also, mainly possibly towards diabetics, but to be honest, I'm not the picture perfect diabetes, but maybe also to people who are non-diabetics and how they could help people they know that with diabetes and things that they shouldn't do, because there's kind of a lot of things that kind of irk me what people think. I actually had to look up the year because I didn't commit the year to memory. I've been a type 1 diabetic for 8 years. I was diagnosed September 20th, 2006, 2 months before my 13th birthday, so that kind of sucked. And it was 2 days before my mother's birthday, so that sucked even more. I felt horrible. Basically, how we figured it out was the week before I was diagnosed, I was just sick constantly. I couldn't keep any food down. My lips were dry, I was dehydrated, I was vomiting all the time, it was just really bad. We went to my primary care physician and he thought I either had the flu or a really bad stomach virus. So, you know what he told me to do? He told me, drink some juice to replace all the fluids that you're losing. Which, obviously, as you could tell, that made things a lot worse. And so the day after he told me that, when I kept throwing up during the night, my parents decided that it was time to take me to the emergency room. Because obviously the physician was wrong. By that morning, I could barely stand, and so my mom had to actually help me get into the shower to get ready. And while I was in the shower, my primary care physician called and was like, you need to get into the emergency room ASAP because they did blood work and my sugar was really high. So I didn't know what was going on at the time, because again, I was 12, I didn't know what was going on. They rushed me to the emergency room, and I can remember this is actually kind of embarrassing. I remember them pulling my parents over to the side, and I heard the word diabetes, and I shot up from the bed that I was in, and I was like, no more Starbucks? Because at that time, it was when drinking coffee when you're a teenager started to be the thing to do, and so I was just like, oh my god, I can't be a teenager anymore. But then after that, I passed out, and I was in and out of a coma for, I'm not sure how long. I don't even want to really ask anymore because that was just kind of pushed aside. When I woke up, they basically told me what happened, that I was type 1 diabetic. I really did not know what that meant at that time because I didn't have any knowledge of what it was. I was 12. I was 12. I was just like, I don't know how I'm going to deal with this, really. And it was really scary. And they told me I lost 7 pounds in 3 days, which obviously is not normal. And I was just like, I don't know how I'm going to do all of this. They kept me in hospital for a week to monitor me and tell me how I'm gonna have to live the rest of my life, basically, and how I'm gonna have to take care of myself. Which, at 12 years old, it was kind of overwhelming. And also what actually affected me more was that, like I said earlier, it was 2 days before my mother's birthday. I felt so, so bad that she had to spend her birthday in the hospital. I felt so bad, actually, that the day of her birthday, I asked the nurse and the doctor secretly. I was like, if I'm really, really good, can I please just have a little, can I get a cake and have just a little slice for my mother's birthday? Because I felt so, so bad. It was tough. I mean, it was a really tough time. I remember thinking, why me? Why did this have to happen to me? I mean, what did I do? But, I mean, now I know there's other things that are much, much worse, but there's still times where I'm just like, I'm sick of this, but I'll get to that later. It was a really hard adjustment. So at this time, since the previous year, I was in 7th grade and I was in the drama program at my school. I was in middle school at the time, obviously, and I was in the school play, and even though I was like one of the background characters, I had so much fun, and I was like, this is what I want to do with my life. But then once I was diagnosed, I kind of was turned against it by my own reasons, no one else's reasons, because I was just afraid. I was like, I don't know how I'm gonna do this. What if my sugar goes low during the play? How would I react? How would I do that? That would ruin the play. I don't know. I couldn't handle it at the time. I remember I hated, and I still kind of hate, checking my sugar in front of people. I could do it in front of my closest friends, but like people that I'm just meeting at school, if we go out or whatever, and I have to check my sugar, I'm kind of doing it in the bottom of my backpack, and they're like, what are you looking for? And I'm just like, nothing, even though they kind of know that I'm a diabetic. It's just, it's still weird. Like, pricking your finger and having blood come out in front of people, like, that's not normal. At that time, I kind of let it stop me from doing things. I still, at times, let it stop me from doing things, because some of it's just like, what happens if my sugar goes low and I pass out somewhere? It's kind of scary. But at the same time, I don't want to let it get to me and let me stop things. And I remember when a few years ago, before I started college, I was reading posts from people with type 1 diabetes, and the endocrinologists were telling them, like, that they basically couldn't really go to college, otherwise their sugars were gonna be totally messed up and ruined. And that is such a lie. If anybody tells you that, it is a lie. I went to college. I did my undergraduate in 3 years. I'm doing my graduate now. I'm gonna become a physical therapist, and it's possible. I will tell you now that it is possible. Yes, your sugars will be a little hectic with stress and stuff, but that's gonna happen in normal everyday life anyway. 8 years later, it's become a part of my everyday life, obviously. It's pretty sad that I can't remember not being a diabetic, so I'm kinda happy I got it when I was younger than if I got it now, because I would not have good habits at all. Not saying that I have good habits now. I feel like it was easier getting it younger because I've gotten used to it into adulthood now. Yeah, I should mention I was 12 when I was diagnosed, and I'm turning 21 this week. So that's basically a short rundown of my story. There were still times when I'm kind of like, why did I have to get this? There are lots of times when my sugar is high or low, and I did everything right. I counted my carbs right, I took all my insulin, I calculated everything right, and it still just, your sugar's still high for some reason, and that's gonna happen. Because of stress, weather, anything, you're just getting sick, a lot of things can affect it. So even if you're doing everything right, your sugar still may not be the best that it should. And that can get really frustrating. And there are times, I don't know if anybody has heard of it, it's called, or I guess people nicknamed the term diabetes burnout, when you're just kind of sick of having to take care of yourself to live. It's kind of really sad. But I've experienced that frequently, and if you experience that, don't worry, it will normally pass. And just, if you have someone you could talk to about, be a parent or your best friend or whatever, even if they can't understand it really, even if you talk to another diabetic, they can't really understand your struggles because it's different for everybody. But if you could just talk it out to someone, it kind of helps you feel better. Which brings me to my first point of advice is find people that you could trust, that you're comfortable with, and tell them basically everything about how you have to take care of yourself and things to look out for if your sugar's high or low, or what to do if your sugar goes high or low, and if you pass out, what should they do? Because it's really for your security, and it's just a good feeling knowing that you could trust these people enough with your life, basically, and it's really cool. Hopefully you all have at least one person that you could do that with. And now, I don't have much advice for people who are diabetics because I am not picture perfect type 1 diabetic, definitely not. Just do your best. That's all you can do, is just do your best. It's a tough struggle, and people don't understand that. A lot of people don't understand that. A lot of people think it's a joke, which now brings me to my second portion of this video, which is advice for people who don't have diabetes, but know people who have diabetes, or might be, have an acquaintance, whatever. Or just, even if you don't know anybody, these are things that you should not do. These are things that you should not do because it is going to really, really, really upset a bunch of people. Namely, diabetics. Say you're a non-diabetic and you meet someone who has diabetes, specifically type 1 because I don't have experience with type 2. But, so say you meet someone and they're a type 1 diabetic and they tell you, don't, under any circumstances, do not tell them, oh, really? You don't look fat. Or, oh, did you eat too much sugar when you were a kid? Do not say that. Number one, it is fat shaming. Type 1 diabetes is a genetic disorder and it's an autoimmune disease. Type 2 diabetes can also be genetic, and even for those people who were overweight and got it because of that, you don't have a right to judge people based on their lifestyle. You do not have a right. You don't know their life. There's many different factors in that. There's social economic status, emotional stability, and all this other stuff, and it's just a very complex thing. You shouldn't put that stigma on people, diabetic or not, actually. So you know what? Just be a nice person overall. Also, just don't tell them, oh, did you eat a lot of sugar? Because that is stupid, and that's not how it works. If you really want to be nice, you could actually look up how type 1 diabetes occurs and inform yourself. Another thing that you should not do is make any joke at a diabetic expense, diabetes expense, any expense. The most common ones that I have seen that I hate with a passion is the whole, John has 54 candy bars and he ate 37 of them. What does John have now? Diabetes. John has diabetes. That's not how it works. And also tagging stuff on Instagram or Twitter, all sugary foods with like hashtag diabetes, or I'm gonna eat this whole cake, oh my god, I'm gonna get diabetes. Don't do that. It's wrong. You're making a joke about a serious illness. I don't see you making jokes about Tom had 74 cigarettes and he smoked 64. What does he have now? Lung cancer. Or, oh, I'm gonna smoke this whole pack of cigarettes, I'm gonna get lung cancer. People don't joke about that. An illness is an illness regardless. You shouldn't make a joke about any illness, no matter the severity. Just because they're on different spectrums doesn't give you the right to make a joke. And one of the last pieces of advice that I'm gonna give you is, if you meet a type 1 diabetic and you know someone, your uncle's, father's, aunt's, second cousin twice removed has diabetes and had their foot removed or went blind, we don't really need to know that. It's kind of stressful enough dealing with their sugars and actually being afraid of that happening. We don't really want to hear about that happening to someone because it makes it more real. It's enough for us to kind of be afraid every night that we're not going to wake up because our sugar's going to go too low during the night, or we're going to wake up blind because our sugar's been too high for a week. This is our reality, and you really shouldn't scare people like that. So that was my story and my quick rant about diabetes and the things that I've come across as a type 1 diabetic. If you are a type 1 diabetic, let me know how you're doing with it, how you felt about your diagnosis, and how you feel about it now, and how you live your life, if you let it stop you, if you let it motivate you, because I know some people let it motivate. I wish I was more like that. And if you have any tips, you could leave them down below, because we could all use a little help now and then. We can live with this. It's hard, but we can. And just know that there's other people who are going through the same thing if you're having troubles, and we will all make it through. See you guys later. Bye!